up, guys? Welcome to my channel, Tarot by the Intuitive Teacup. My name is Annie. I welcome you to come into these tarot readings with an open heart, an open mind, and a desire to better yourself. This is optional advice or guidance meant to motivate you, empower you, inspire you, and offer you confirmations on things that you are already thinking and feeling and sensing. If you don't resonate with the material that comes through, please push those messages aside. They may resonate for you at a later date, and they may not. Have faith it's going out to someone who needs to hear it, even if it is not you. Use your logic, your discretion, your discernment. Separate what is meant for you and what is not. I come at this with love and positivity, so please take that away here today. You are responsible for all your own actions and decisions. Let's try and have some fun to get you some insightful messages. Check out that box below for the decks I use, how to contact me for a personal, as well as my social media links. Welcome to the tea party. Let's read your tarot cards. What's up, Cancer? Welcome to your December mid-monthly tarot reading. We're going to do it a little bit different this time. I've already pulled the cards and shuffled off camera, so we're going to hop right in right now. Here we go. First card out the deck was Queen of Cups. I really, really love this. I just think it's such a beautiful card. It always makes me think of... This is so random, but Batman and Robin with like Lady Freeze. Do you remember like Arnold Schwarzenegger's wife was like frozen or she's in some like glass case with water, but it's very like angelic and beautiful and serene. But actually that whole thing may be an issue or a metaphor rather for like a almost like Lady Freeze, like time to thaw out. It could even indicate some sort of healing from a medical issue. Anyway, circling back to your tarot reading, which is why we're here. Something about that metaphor may actually mean something deeper than just Batman and Robin. You know what I mean? Queen of Cups is you. I feel like you're reaching for something, but you feel like you don't have enough knowledge. And so I see you driving yourself a little bit crazy. There's a sense of anarchy of trying to get your hands on every piece of information rather than just using the knowledge you have and making slow steps forward or understanding that this is going to be a process or something about progress. You've already come a very long way in this, and so it's certainly not saying abandon ship, don't give up, because I'm literally seeing this Hierophant. This is about commitment and tradition and order in a sense, but just sheerly by the way it's depicted, it's like it's anarchy. There's writings and sketches and information all around you, so this could have to do with a degree you're working towards or some sort of thesis or novel you're writing or any sort of creative endeavor, or even in your work, right? Maybe it's like documents for work. It's like I see you wanting to ascend, and this could be wanting to get a raise or wanting to feel like get your head above water. You could feel like you've been sinking in debt, and so you're trying to get your finances order. Something about that, it's very chaotic, but it's sort of asking you to quiet your mind. I don't see this problem going away, but the thing is, it's because there's something very, very important to be gained here. In your highest vibration, we know that in a sense, Eight of Swords indicates you've put yourself in a mental prison. So ultimately, Cancer, this is about changing your perspective to understand that you may be acting out of nervousness or acting out of fear, that perhaps what you're wanting and desiring out of this process, it's almost like, oh my gosh, have I put too much energy into this and I'm not going to get the desired outcome? That's not here, but it is saying you may be thinking that, in which case you need to change your patterns of thought. You need to change your way of thinking, because essentially you're locking yourself into this conclusion that it isn't real. It's actually based on, you know, negative thought or a lack of self-confidence or self-doubt. The swords are pointed down, right? They're not helpful. When the swords are up, typically in tarot, that means they're vibing high. They're, you know, they're receiving messages and communications from a higher power, from a higher source. Here they're down, and again, it's become your mental prison. So you need to break free. I think you need freedom from the craziness. I said something really similar to, I think, who was it? Was it Gemini or Pisces? I think it was Pisces. So, you know, water signs, right? You need to get out of the environment or change it up in a way where it promotes a more healthy work life or work style. I get the sense that you're either nervous or I'm sort of getting chaos and you're just stifled. A lot of you feel like you're on a treadmill and like you have a finite point of time where you have to make this end goal or you have to make this deadline or make this due date. Here's the thing, Cancer, it really doesn't matter in the long run if you do, because universe is saying to me, stick with this. Something really good is going to come out of this, but you're shooting yourself in the foot, possibly by giving yourself too strict of a time limit. Especially if you're knee deep in like research or trying to take an extra course or become like excel at some sort of skill or become a teacher of any kind, spiritual, educational, whatever you want to say. You're not you're not in the clear yet, but you're being asked to not abandon it. But to, it's almost, I think I've said this to you before, it's not about working harder, it's about working smarter. You may need to delegate responsibilities or ask people for help, or you may need to set more, what is a good term for it? Almost like a logical work pace. Does that make sense? There's a really great word for that that I'm missing. It's like set yourself up for success by establishing healthy time limits and healthy times in which you're participating in this and knee deep in it, and then step away from it, walk away from it. Because I do feel like you're, it's almost like the idea of gasping for breath. It's like you're trying to get ahead, but the thing is, you do see value in this, or you wouldn't have put yourself in this situation. So even if you're in a situation that you dislike, you know, example, going back to school or this or that, which I'm not necessarily encouraging, I'm just showing you the cards here, right? It's saying you got into this for a reason, so you need to remember the purpose of why you started this in the first place. And also, you may be very strict in, no, it has to be this. You may need to be a little bit more flexible or loosey-goosey on the end goal or the end product. Clearly, it's going to be in the same realm or in the same area, but I'm almost getting, it's like the novel takes an unexpected twist and turn, and so rather than fighting it and almost like, I'm seeing you like grabbing the steering wheel back, like, no, we're headed that way. What if the universe says, really? Because you should be headed that way, but you're fighting it? Ultimately, it's like you need to listen to the preachings of the universe, the messages you're getting, the signs around you. They're helping you steer the ship or drive the car, however you want to say it, in a direction that is for your best and highest good. They are steering you away from pessimism or negativity. There's something about needing to liberate your mind. Quite literally, you need to see this from a different perspective. You need to take off the blindfold. Maybe you need to fly. Maybe you need to travel or, again, change your environments. So in the past, what you have coming up is a Page of Wands. So again, this to me says there has been a spark of communication or a spark of creativity, a spark of magic, right? The magic wand, the conductor, the magician, however you want to say it, where you've already started to, I'm almost seeing you writing notes on music sheets or music charts. I don't know if some of you may be learning an instrument or learning, learning some sort of creative process or something that is going to add to the tools in your tool belt, right? You're becoming the master of this new craft or this new endeavor. The page says to me, it's not brand new, you've already been working on it, but you're struggling. You're driving the struggle bus right now, and I think it's because you are looking at it from a very singular perspective. Possibly, for some of you, this might be saying you're so in your head about this, you actually need some fresh perspective. You need some, maybe some new viewpoints, some new opinions. So if you feel comfortable, I would obviously keep it under wraps in terms of not putting it out to the whole world, although maybe that applies to you, right? There's something about, I'm getting a multiple messages here about perfectionism is going to be your enemy because you will never be perfect. I'm telling you right now, Cancer, this is a tough love message, but I would say it to every single zodiac sign. And that message is not unique to this reading. You will never be perfect because there will always be one critic out there. So it doesn't matter. The only person who really matters in this is you, and I guess technically the universe, whatever you believe in. Obviously, if you're trying to appeal to, you know, the masses, you know, the vendors, the clients, the whoever, sure, you need to take them into consideration. But if this extension is, or this product is essentially an extension of you, your heart and soul has to be put into it. And then that's what's going to draw people to it is your individuality. Not your fear. I'm almost getting this weird metaphor of like by even thinking these negative thoughts or this having this defeatist attitude about it, it's almost like you're mixing that into the ingredients of what you're concocting, whatever you're, you know, cooking in the kitchen. You're adding a dash of fear or a dash of, you know, whatever, subconsciously because it's involved in the energetic space that you're doing this in. So it's almost like you got to clean house a little bit. Like I said the same thing to another sign. It's like you almost literally have to like sage the house and just like, okay, no more negative energy. And also allow new thoughts and ideas, welcome it in. I it's so funny. This is reminding me of a book I just read. It was, what is it called? Big Magic, Elizabeth Gilbert. And I recommend it, sure, especially if you're a creative. I'm not getting endorsed to promote it. I just wanted you to know that. But it actually talks a lot about picture creativity as if it were a person in your life. If it comes knocking at the door, you know, don't be suspicious of it. Don't, you know, hide behind the curtains or whatever. It's like, welcome it in. Have a conversation with it. Even if you're a little bit suspicious of, well, I thought I was writing a detective novel, but all of a sudden, you know, creativity, universe, God is telling me it's a romance story. Like, It's almost like, prove your case. What do you have to offer me? But by blocking it entirely, you may be denying yourself of something very important. Be open to the twists and turns. I am getting the end goal will be roughly the same, although for some of you, that's not true. It's going to be completely different. It will be worth it in the end. You have big things coming at the end, but there's something about you're like midway through the process, or it could even be the beginnings of it, and you're already having these fears or these self-doubts. We got to kick that habit. That's not healthy. It's not going to help you in this. You quite literally need to raise your vibration. It's like you're drowning under sea. And some of you, you have too much work on your plate. You're taking too many responsibilities and claiming them as your own. If you have a child that could help, if you have a husband, a wife, a friend who you could ask for a favor, or just take some responsibility off your plate that allows you more time to accomplish this thing, it would be very beneficial to you. You don't need to be Superman. You don't need to be Superwoman. Delegate accordingly. Delegate some of the tasks and the responsibilities, especially the mundane stuff where it doesn't matter, right? If you're, I'm just giving this as an example. If you're running a creative business and it's keeping you, you know, busy around the clock, hire an admin. Have someone respond to the clients via email. Like, have someone update your Instagram for you. Like, you don't need to do everything and still have it be your own brand or your own business. All right? For a lot of you, I don't know how else to phrase this other than this feels like you are trying to get a degree or trying to get, again, a class under your belt or master some sort of concept. You may be learning a new language or something about foreign language, but like foreign currency is what I'm getting, or mathematics, I don't know, science, anything. It's almost like my full-grown adults feel like they're going back to school again, and it's really overwhelming. So maybe you're finishing up a course, which, by the way, you're going to graduate. That's what this card means. But we're in the thick of it now, so how can I help you here? Let's look at this closer. Your Page of Wands, again, the inspiration was there, and then I think it went, and you guys are frustrated. You're like, what happened to that magic I felt when I started this project? It will come back, but you have to, again, honestly, like, speak to it as if it were an entity, a being. Ask creativity to come visit you again, you know? I know that sounds really silly and kind of hippy-dippy, but you'd be surprised, Cancer. Although some of you know exactly what I'm talking about. Some of you do that already, so keep doing it. The creativity will come back. Yeah, and it has a lot. I'm allowing you to view this from any perspective you want. Love, romance, family, you know, platonic love, work, career. I have to read this through career because that's the strongest message coming to me, Cancer. So if you want to try and view this through love, by all means, take it and run with it. You may have marriage with a Taurus online, or marriage with a Cancer, a female water sign, Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. Sure, we can make it that, but I'm going to read it the way I'm seeing it. Come to me the strongest, okay? Just so you know. So again, this has to do with work. I'm hearing manual labor too. So it's like, what are you breaking your back to do? And can you simplify? Can you delegate? Can you work smarter, but not harder? Do you understand what I mean? Because that's where we're at. I don't think you can take on any more workload or any more responsibility. And I know some of you are watching this going, I don't have a choice. I have to go do this. Okay, but it's asking you, then where can you take away? If you have to go do this project, this assignment, this responsibility, where can you compensate and be like, you know what, this month I'm not going to do that. Maybe this has to do with saving money, cutting costs. Again, you need to be smarter about it. So, okay, interesting. Coming up in your hopes and fears. So I see this as such a message of duality. You have 10 of Pentacles. So yeah, your hopes are, I hope this is lucrative. I hope that by completing this course or doing this thing, the money starts to flow again. Others of you are like, holy cannoli, I invested so much money in this degree, or I invested so much money in this house. Like, whatever it is, it's like, I hope it works out. I hope I can get the money back or achieve whatever was taken out of my fundings or my bank account. I hope I can get my head above water again, right? Money, quite clearly, you have so many pentacles here, seems to be the main concern coming through here. So it might not be your message, Cancer, right? Keep that in mind. But for a lot of you, it is. A lot of you are going to be tremendous writers. You're writing a book. And again, it's like creativity is waiting to strike, but it's not here. It's like it came and it went. So the mere fact that it came knocking on your door once, Cancer, it will come back, but you need to stop telling yourself that it won't. That it's like, oh, I'm screwed now. I lost all sources of income. I've lost all sources of creativity. Again, get out of that negative headspace. I am getting a message of changing up your environment, especially if you're writing. Try writing, you know, by the ocean. You know, if you can afford it, rent an Airbnb for the weekend and, you know, write at the seaside or whatever works for you, right? If maybe you're like Stephen King, maybe you like going into a dark basement, closing the door, and you know what I mean? Like doing it in like this kind of like this dark, almost like sacred, I'm almost getting like womb of the belly or womb of the house. That actually would make a lot of sense for Cancer, especially Cancers who have strong Scorpio in their chart. Anyway, find an environment that matches your needs in order to tap into that creativity because it's there. It didn't go away. It's just something was blocking you. And again, I hate to say it. It sounds like I'm being mean to you. It was your own doing though. It's you who's blocking it. So allow it to flow in new and different ways. I don't have all the solutions. I don't have all the answers. I can just tell this has to do with changing your perspective or your mind. And some of you, again, it's that message of it's okay to change your mind. You may have, again, metaphors. You may have started writing a book on a detective story and then it became a romance novel. And you know what? It looks like it's going to be a pretty good one. So don't fight it anymore. Don't fight the inevitable. And I mean, you have to weigh out what the stakes are, right? But my agent told me I had to do it. It's your life, Cancer. Do it for you. Don't do it for your agent. So what can I tell Cancer if they are in financial debt? If Cancer is worried about money, what is the best thing I can tell them, please? What is the best advice or guidance for my Cancers who are in financial strain? Four of Cups. Again, weighing out your options. To me, this says, where can you cut? There's something about an apprehensive nature. Look, he's literally got his little Cancer bandana thing on there too. It's saying, okay, you may have had to overcompensate or you may have had, you know, car issues and money went to that this month. Where can you cut back? You know, can you cancel Netflix for 2 months? Would it kill you? And I mean, that's one example, Cancer, but it's making a firm assessment on where is your money going to? Where are all these streams of income coming from and where are they going out? You need to have more coming in right now than going out. You need to be money savvy, or you need to start looking for new streams of income. Here's the thing though, based on the skills you already have, because as we said, you don't really have much more room to extend into any other area. So this is about, again, just examples. If you have old paintings that are sitting in your art studio, put them on Etsy, you know, put them on, I don't know, Craigslist or whatever artists do, right? Patreon, you know, taking what you already have and just putting it up there. So you're allowing the universe to send you blessings for what you've already created. I actually do get the fact that you're sitting on creativity. There might be some, and this could even be gutting out your closets, your attic, your basement. You may have valuable things, but you don't need them anymore. And it's saying, hey, a lot of people would buy that from you. So put on Amazon Marketplace or whatever you use, right? It's sort of about decluttering your life, which interestingly enough will help you to declutter your mental space because it's energy. It's taking up energy in your house. And so by default, your house is where you live. Energetically, you're interacting with that space every day. Some of it is cluttering your mind too. Yeah, and I know that's not this like crazy innovative solution, but you know, you're asking what can I do if money is tight? You need to cut the funding. You need to cut the expenditures. I actually heard by half. Give yourself a monthly budget. You need to plan ahead and not act impulsively when you're spending money. If you're bored, don't go to Target if you know you're going to spend money there on stuff you don't need, right? It's again, it's about realigning your headspace. What is the thought or the intention behind doing something? And is it contributing positively to you, to your self-love, but also to your bank account? You have something very important to sell, Cancer, that is unique to you. It's different and it's a little kooky and it's a little bit bizarre. And I think some of you are viewing that as a downfall, but that's actually what people are going to like about it. That's what's going to make it, you know, in demand, is because it's slightly left of center. It's slightly different and it's like signature you. I'm not even going to say it's signature Cancer because it's different for all of you out there. It's signature, you know, Sarah. It's signature David. It's, you know, whoever. It's something very specific to you. That is the part that's very marketable. Do it your own way. Do it with your creative signature, your creative flair, especially if you have strong Leo in your chart. Some of you are natural born entertainers. You have 10 of Pentacles again. Some of you may end up having to cut expenditures by moving in with a family member or getting a roommate. Or I'm sort of making some sort of compromise about either your living situation or something regarding a family member. It doesn't have to be forever. It could be temporary. Actually, you know, I said the same thing, I think, to Sagittarius, maybe. Anyway, it's ultimately saying something about... Ten of Pentacles to me is such a family card, generational ancestry. It could have to do with quite literally mending fences or something about getting... this sounds so random, but getting the neighbors involved... It could be that you're doing some sort of charity organization or raising funds for your, I don't know what this is, Cancer. I hit a wall there. What is that? What is that? Okay, you need to be more creative and get out of the comfort zone. Okay, so here's what I mean. The traditional way of how you've always approached making money, you need to totally rethink your, why am I endorsing all my favorite books on my channel tonight? What is that book called? I always tell you guys about it. You are a badass at making money. You need to totally flip the script and change your perspective on the way you view money and income. And the way you view yourself as like a valuable commodity, some of you just, you have great ideas and great talents, but you lack the self-confidence to put it out there. And like, the thing is, Ten of Pentacles, you're asking me about money. You have tremendous cards for money, Cancer. And there's better ones too. So whatever it is, we just got to get it up and out. We got to start blocking our blessings. I am getting something about fences. Or bridging the gap, bridges, fences, whatever is the obstacle and the barrier between you and the end goal, the destination, you need to plow through it. You need to find a way through. This could even be representative of like your boss is the one who controls the income. So, you know, whether you choose to do this literally or metaphorically, you know, knocking on the boss's door and demanding a raise or I need to speak to you about my whatever, it's intimidating, but that's no reason to not do it. And if for some reason you get denied that, you know, whatever, that position, that loan, that sum of money that you're asking for or wanting or desiring, okay, that's one person. Find it somewhere else. I'm almost getting don't take no for an answer. You need to channel your kind of very masculine energy here and tenacity. You guys are known for, I want this and so I'm going to hold on to it. So Cancer, I'm going to throw this one at you and I know you guys are going to be a little bit offended, but go with, like, trust that I mean that with love. The way, I'm going to say we, because I have a lot of Cancer in my chart personally. The way we love to hold on to people and romantic partners and sentimentality and relationships of the past, you need to apply that same tenacity and stick-to-itiveness to your creativity, to your skills, to your future, to your success in the career and business world. Some of you, I have to say it, I am not a tarot reader who likes to overindulge in the tarot readings or make false promises of things that aren't coming in for you. But I have to be honest, the fact that you have Ten of Pentacles twice indicates to me some of you have a large sum of money coming to you. It's almost like universe is saving it for you, but there's one final obstacle you have to conquer, and it does have to do with doing that thing you're afraid to do. And for some of you, it's uprooting yourself and leaving your hometown or leaving your comfort zone, moving away from your family. Again, it doesn't have to be forever. It could simply be to take that course, but you have to go to England to do it or whatever. Leaving the comfort zone, which again, by nature, you guys are the fourth house, which is the house and the home. And we like to be cozy and in our little shell. Only you've outgrown the shell. That's really what you've graduated from, right? So this whole theme of graduation is sprinkled throughout. It's time to conquer that thing you never thought you could. So yeah, for those struggling with money, you need to keep like a tally, a running list of money coming in and out, and make sure the money coming in is more. You really need to focus on that and spend time doing it. Like, I'm seeing data and Excel spreadsheets. Now for those who your hopes and your wishes and dreams are Ten of Pentacles, some of you are trying to raise money for to move your parent or to fund your child's college education. It's like I see you needing to raise a bunch of money for the family. I don't even think it's directly related to you, though more or less it could be. You may be trying to buy your first home if you've always rented. What can I tell Cancer if they're looking to acquire more money, please? Music, musicians. Some of you are musically talented. The Star and the Five of Pentacles. Ugh, Cancer, you're making me work for it. So the Star is a great card. Wishes and hopes and dreams. Balance. Okay, this is saying you need to be patient. And you had a very bad experience, and this is in the past, at a workplace where someone was extremely, I'm getting verbally abusive, and it really shook you. Or it could have even been someone you grew up with. You could have had a father or a mother or a grandfather, whoever. There was someone you once interacted with them. And I'm almost getting that it was extremely sensitive and vulnerable for you because it had to do with something you loved and were very passionate about. And I think you wanted to pursue possibly as a child, but it could have been recently too. And that person completely tore you to bits about it. Or they didn't even have to do much. It's like they said that one thing that really got under your skin where you started to question if you could do it. And so I think some of you started to believe their truth. It was never your truth, but because you were told that possibly several times, you started to take it on as your truth. flat out cancer, I don't see that in the cards. I see that someone said something really vicious to you and it really shook you. It scared you to the point where you were thinking of abandoning this career or this idea entirely. And yet it keeps knocking at your door, doesn't it? You keep circling back to it, even mentally. As much as you want to move away from it because you're afraid or intimidated by it, that's not a valid excuse, cancer. I really, again, this is tough love. I say it with so much compassion, guys. When opportunity knocks, you need to open the door, even if for some reason you're like, oh, but I can't be an actress, I can't be a singer, I can't be a dancer. Really? Whose truth is that? Who told you that? If it was anyone but you, then, you know, it doesn't matter. And if it is you, even more so. Again, we got to flip the script, change the perspective. Here's the thing, guys, and flat out, this isn't fun to hear, but it's the truth of the matter. What society views as practical jobs, it keeps you in a state of boredom and complacency for a lot of us. And I don't mean this for everyone. Whatever career you're passionate about, that is your truth. Go for it. But, you know, for my classic, you know, teachers, bankers, lawyers, doctors, you know, whatever is like a typical or not even typical, but standard job, professional, right? Something, that's not professional. So any intuitive, spiritual, creative artist, a lot of you ended up in a job where you are miserable and that, you know, opportunity knocks of, oh, but remember when you wanted to be a novelist? Remember when you wanted to be a filmmaker? Remember when you wanted to act and sing and dance on stage? That idea doesn't seem to be going anywhere. It's like, I would be worried if it was an abusive ex that kept coming back, but it's not. It's your hopes and your dreams and your wishes that are like, hey, remember me? It's almost, again, like putting your hopes and dreams and wishes, imagining them as another entity. They keep knocking at your door and it's like you keep turning them away because you're afraid. And that's okay, Cancer. I'm not beating up on you, but it's time to conquer your fear. That's what this whole message is about. I'm also being called to tell you, look at the stars, look at the zodiac, look at your birth chart, right? So look at avenues where you could potentially make money. So again, there are very easy tutorials on YouTube that can kind of map out for you briefly, you know, where you can look to make money. But I would say your second house, your sixth house, your 10th house, those three houses, those placements, the planets that are there, the signs that rule them, are going to show you where you have very lucrative opportunities and opportunities that are available to you, but maybe aren't as important in your life path, right? I believe in free will, but I also believe in birth charts. So that's a conundrum, right? No, but for real, if you're looking for more opportunities for income, you should really look into your birth chart. It's just telling me to tell you, look at your stars, look at your planet, look at your North Star, look at your midheaven, look at your 10th house, career placements. A lot of my cancers, it's saying you have money in your birth chart. You just have to find it. It's almost like you need to, in a very page of wands way, almost look at it as an adventure. It's almost like look at your birth chart as a treasure map. Like, where can I find the treasure? Like, I know it's here somewhere. You're right. It's definitely there, but you have to find it. And I think in order to find it, you have to do something a little bit scary, or I'm going to say like out of your comfort zone. This is eights in tarot, any eight, ultimately, they lead to liberation. We think of the Eight of Wands, it's those straight wands flying through the air. It's a card of travel and communication. And anyway, this eight, right? It's a prison though. So again, the metaphor of liberation from the prison, that's what's coming in for you, but you really need to tackle your fear. You need to ascend. You need to grow in your spiritual path. So here's the cool thing. I see you taking a risk coming into your immediate future. Look at her face. She started to build something. She started to grow. She started to invest more in it, in the business, in herself maybe, right? She looks a little bit nervous, but she's doing it anyway. And she, I don't read for gender per se. Look at that. It's a victory just taking the first step. The first step is the scariest, Cancer. It will be worth it in the end. And only you guys can decide when the timing is right. I have no control over your timing, right? This is saying the energy is available. So, hey, if you want to take this message now and start writing that novel, click off the channel, go write it. If you want to sit and think on this and write the novel in 2 weeks or 2 months or 2 years, the energy stands. It's always going to be here, right? This is your reading, Cancer. But why would you want to sit on this? Why would you want to sit any longer on this opportunity that I just keep getting this metaphor? It keeps knocking. Do you see all these doors? Look at this. You have a theme of doors and obstacles. You're supposed to push past the door. You're not supposed to settle for what other people are preaching at you. Other people's truth, almost like dogma, what other people are telling you you should do or what you should have or how much you should make. Is that what you even want? I feel like some of you got involved in a long-term career and it's almost like, I hate to use the term midlife crisis, but to be honest, that's sort of what I'm getting. It's like you've been at something for so long that you're like, is this all I ever get in life? Like, I don't think I'm happy anymore. That realization is the key that's going to unlock the door, because now you can act on that realization. Rather than staying in the prison of false beliefs, now you can be like, oh, there is something else out there for me. Like, I want to do this. I want to achieve this. And I know you do. This is, you do have hopes and dreams, Cancer. So whether you believe it or not, they know you exist. Are you acknowledging them, you know? All right, what is Cancer building here? I'm going to switch decks. What is Cancer building here? In the near future, what's coming in is mind, body, and spirit. I see you participating more in healthy spiritual activities. I also see you possibly getting involved in real estate or something involving selling homes or traveling to see different homes. You could be doing something in the field of hospitality. Also fashion. I see some of you doing something with like fashion or fancy ball gowns or something like that. I don't know if it's costuming for a theater or acting or something where like, what do you call that? A fitting. So it could even be for wedding dresses, right? I see something about a costume fitting or wardrobe fitting. And that may have to do with your career. Or you may be buying like a very nice tailored suit or this or that or jacket to go on like an interview or something to do with maybe the way you're shifting in your, I don't know what this is, Cancer, but it has to do with your career. You're getting fit for a certain size something, and maybe it's not even you, maybe it's not clothing, maybe it's measurements of fabric for your thing, or there's something there about clothing or fabric or something. Even book bindings or the coverings of a book, I don't know what that is. Anyway. Some of you are going to work with a Sagittarius or someone who's an angel of healing. That's sort of how it's being relayed to me. Okay, so some of you are getting crazy important messages from your spirit guides. And the thing is, I want to say they're urgent, but it's not to promote fear in you. It's not like be wary, Cancer. It's not that. It's urgent because it's almost like you finally had that epiphany of, oh, maybe I should do this. And your spirit guides are like, yes, please. It's almost like, it's so funny. I'm seeing people at like a stadium at a football game with like, you know, horn blowers and hats and confetti. And they're like, yes, Cancer, yes. So they're trying to help you. You just having that initial, again, like switching your mind or perspective to even start considering to build this thing more or try something new. Spirit is trying to get your attention so that they can help you through the process, so they can help align you as you build this more or start to build this, okay? Yes, especially a Sagittarius in your life may be very influential. And some of you are just, you're meant to build a career in which you act as a healer, where you bring love and empathy and compassion into the lives of others. It's like in metaphor, what you do in your career, it's like you wrap someone in your angel wings and then you release them and they're like a changed person. So you could even work as like a psychic medium or something. I'm almost getting like spiritualistic type healing. And certainly it could be medical healers, right? Anything like physical therapy or radiology or whatever, fill in the blank. But it's like you have an intuitive gift. And I have to be honest, so much of this feels very artistic and creative and inspired type. Painters, artists, singers, dancers, sewers, costumers, whatever it is for you. I'm actually seeing film reels like in a camera here. So again, filmmakers. Sharing stories, writing stories, playwrights, novelists. You have 10 of Pentacles twice, Cancer. How do I get you on board with this idea? Universe says commit to it. Commit to it because you know you're meant to ascend in this area. It's just you've been blocking your blessings or delaying it. And I get it, Cancer, but I am being called to say out of fear. Acknowledging fear. Fear is the opposite of love, right? We got to beat fear. That's like the key to all of this. Some of you were also like diagnosed with something medically, and I am getting ages ago where the thing is, it wasn't pressing. Here's what I'm getting is that you finally need to go and have that procedure, or you finally need to go and have it checked out because there's something that's been bothering you and you're a little bit worried about it. But again, you're letting fear stop you from confronting that issue or that obstacle. You need to go and have it healed or have it looked at. And I am getting something about like medically. Again, I don't do fear-based readings, guys. I'm just putting it out there. If that's your message, you'll know it because it's going to offer you that confirmation of, oh shit, I am supposed to do that, right? Like, oh, I keep canceling that blood work appointment or, you know, something like that. It could even be dental, something about, yeah, medical. So that's what I mean. Like, it's not like life or death. It's like, oh yeah, I do have that like weird crowning thing pop. I don't know. It's something like that. Anyway. Oh, Cancer. These are always so long. Oh, look at you. What do you have coming in? You're stepping out of your fear. You're building outside the familiar. Because this has been your prison. This has been your home, but it's a false comfort zone. There's a false sense of security here. Sure, it's familiar. You know it. So in a sense, I guess it's comfortable. But it's not that comfortable. And the thing is, I don't think you realize how uncomfortable it is until you make that leap of faith to leave it and realize how liberating it is on the outside. This is an interesting message, too. Some of you may be literally working with... I don't think for most of you it's prisoners, but it might be in terms of you offer spiritual healing or like, you know, help put them on the right path. You may be involved with like ex-convicts or even people in like almost getting like mental ward or victims, like 12th house, the hidden, you know, the prison, the insane asylum, the this or that. And I don't need to be insensitive, but you may offer your spiritual gifts to those who need it most. People who really need that cozy little like angel wing hug that you provide. You may be quite literally working with some people who are like last chancers before they, do you understand what I mean? If that's your message, you'll know it. Ironically, there's this beautiful yin and yang to, in metaphor, of course, that's been your situation. You've been living in a prison, so wouldn't it make sense for you to actually work with people who've been in prison? I know that's very specific, guys, but you could even be making a film or writing about something that takes place in prison. Like, you know, everything comes up for a reason. This tarot reason is chock full, or tarot reading is chock full of symbolism for you. All right. So how do you see yourself? Ten of Wands. Poor Cancer, you're exhausted. But look, you have the star. You have the star of healing and hope. All right, this is about rallying. One more time, Cancer. Look at your track record. Look at your history. You're still here. You're still showing up to this tarot reading. That means by default, you are looking to improve yourself. You're looking to grow. Don't give up yet. I know it's hard. I know it's been a hell of a year, right? This is like 2020 in a nutshell. Just like, I'm exhausted. Like, when does this life end or something like that? What is that? Stop, I want to get off. Right, life. Stop, I want to get off. That's sort of what I'm hearing, like a merry-go-round. The thing is, again, this like something about the cycle. You've been in this cycle too long. You need to leave the comfort zone. You need to do something that is a little bit unfamiliar and don't be intimidated by it. Universe is supporting you on this. And look, you have help available to you. I'll be honest, Cancer, this is a compatibility. This is a match. Certainly, it could indicate spirit guides. I'm going to be honest with you. This indicates partnership and very likely love partnership. So if you are in a happy marriage or a happy relationship, this says to me, lean on your person a little bit. They're going to help you get through. You know, at times where it calls for it and then vice versa. Sometimes the script will flip and your person will need a little extra from you. Others of you, this is saying, universe acknowledges, I know you got put through hell, Cancer, but look, I got something good for you, so this is not the time to quit. You see yourself as ready for a relationship. Are you ready? If fear has played such a huge role in your life of keeping you back from going after your dream career, why can't you say the same for your love relationships? And so I don't know the answer to this, but I do find this message from the cards very interesting. It's like, you're so keen to pursue a relationship, and it's almost like fearless. Like, I want this person, I love them. But why can't you apply the same principles to your love life? Or I'm sorry, your career life, your money, your financial? So again, it's complicated for some of you, but really think about that, right? Especially for my Cancers where fear doesn't hold them back in love. And of course, that's not all of you, but you're so apt to jump into relationships head first or take back your ex. What about taking back your hopes and dreams and your wishes from the past that keep knocking at your door? It's like you're matching with them on the dating apps. I'm talking about your hopes and your dreams. There's signs all around you to do this, and yet you're like, I don't know. I don't know if I can do it. I just think that's a funny message. I think it's very poignant. So how other people see you, the Magician, a master manifester. Good things do come to you. Good things already have come to you. Make sure you express gratitude for what the universe has already blessed you with. So that way you let them know, if you bless me with more, I'm going to continue to be grateful. There's reasons to celebrate your accomplishments in the very near future, Cancer. Liberation is coming through. There's a Gemini or a Virgo who may want to reach out to you for some sort of networking opportunity. It could be someone you worked with in the past, you may end up working with again in the future, specifically on this thing that you're trying to push towards. It's in alignment with your north node, I just heard. So look and see where your north node is. It has something to do with that. And look, there's money tied to it. It's, again, something tied into a very maternally type role, which again, classic cancers, even my male cancers out there, all two of you watching this, right? It's like your mama bear. You're protecting those who need it most. You're offering your wisdom, your guidance, your sympathy, your empathy to people who maybe had a rough hand at life. They got dealt like a rough hand in life. That's sort of what I'm getting. You're helping them to rebuild from their troubled past. And ironically, you're doing the exact same thing for you by default. It's a two for Cancer. They win and you win. And that is working smarter and not harder. Do you see what I did there? Yeah, that's a very cool message. All right, so advice or guidance. We need to get out of the mentality that nothing will ever get better. You're in a Five of Pentacles mode, which interestingly enough over here represented the fear you associate with going after that dream career, or even if it's just a small goal you have. It doesn't have to be your entire career trajectory. Whatever this is, whatever you're allowing fear to impede upon your ability to move forward, Spirit is asking you to face fear in the eye, to look at it and take back your power. You don't control my mind, my decisions. I do. I think I can do this. Even though I'm a little bit scared, I'm going to do it anyway. And also, you're going to see the result of that monetarily. You're going to get out. If you are pinching pennies and money is tight, just taking a simple step forward allows the universe to know that you're ready for the real stuff now. You're ready for settling for small potatoes, for small peanuts. I am getting some issue with health, but here's the thing. Again, I don't predict anything scary. For most of you, this indicates you've already gone through some sort of spiritual awakening where if you were sick as a child or you had some ailment, there could have been some medical advancement or some treatment or some medication that you've started taking, and it's almost life-changing. Actually, this kind of hits close to home a little bit. Interesting. Anyway, this is about you. This is not about me. However, there could have been some sort of change in your health routine, whether even if it's just exercising more, eating better, or it could be, again, a medical prescription that works wonders on you. It's saying you were almost given a second chance. Don't waste it. You know, this is a different story. 10 years ago, you know, you had anxiety, you had depression, you had whatever, bulimia. It could have been something very serious. For most of you, it's saying that's not your story anymore. You already freed yourself from a mental prison ages ago. So what is this last remaining? I don't mean to be insensitive, but I actually like this message because it's very empowering. It's saying you've already done something incredible in terms of turning your life around. You know, maybe you were over-reliant on substances, drinking or drugs or something. Again, it's saying you may have been forced to change your ways, right? I'm just putting that out there, right? You've already conquered a prison before. And again, metaphors, guys, right? So it's like when another one approaches, don't sink into this, oh, well, I guess I'm stuck here. No, you're never stuck here. Look, you're about to fly. You're flying and you're in your natural element here, right? Water, but I also feel like that's symbolic of this career. You would be in your natural element to pursue this thing that you really love. Take back ownership, take back responsibility, take back the control. Again, you're driving the ship, you're driving the car, you're behind the wheel, not your fear, not your shadow side. That's really what it is. I see a lot of you doing something about stained glass windows. So you might be a painter or working in a building that has stained glass windows. It could be very closely related to church and spirituality. It doesn't have to, though. Light still passes through the window even when it's stained glass. I don't even know what that means, but I feel like it's a metaphor. It's not a black curtain. There's nothing. It's not like it's impenetrable. It comes through. It's malleable. It's mutable. You can be the victor over this. And quite literally, your advice or guidance is get out of the state of fear. Do that thing that you're terrified to do because it will be liberating in the end and it offers you peace of mind. But this is also saying like the ultimate like potential outcome if you were to kind of absorb these messages and do with them what you think is valid for you. A whole new world is presented to you. New doors are opened because you found that the key existed in you the whole time. This sounds like the end of a Disney movie. Cheesy. I always say that to you though, right? Cinderella stories for Cancer all the time. Interesting. It's like what was once fixed, all the fixed zodiac signs, what was once stuck, what was once solid and inflexible, suddenly it's like you float right through. It becomes malleable. Again, something about seers, the stars, astrology, if that's an interest of yours, Cancer, I would recommend maybe just reading an article on it, especially about your birth chart. Like, make it more focused on you or your moon sign, learning something. I don't know why I'm telling this to you, because most of my Cancers already know like their moon, their rising, their Venus, but because you guys are like my zodiac lovers. But if you don't, you might want to look into that. Or maybe you're supposed to do something with that. Maybe you're supposed to work in astrology, which, you know, maybe you were told, you know, you're never going to make money doing that. Well, just you wait and see, baby. Cancer's got 10 of pentacles twice. You got the 20 of pentacles, Cancer. Double down on that. I'm almost getting take a risk. It's like gambling or poker. It's like double down on that bet. And it's on yourself. Bet on yourself. That's what you need to do. Opportunities for travel. The end goal or the result at the end of this could be freedom, liberation, and opportunities for travel to see new parts of the country. Yeah, some of you may have strong Sagittarius in your chart, which, you know, the ninth house, which is about travel. And maybe it's mental travel too. Again, astrology through the cosmos. It could be something to do with religion, philosophy, teaching. Teaching something spiritual. You have the Hierophant, right? You may be a spiritual leader of some kind. You may end up traveling with your child or traveling to work with children, or interesting, doing something like psychology with children, particularly healing therapies and arts through painting or something. Or again, I'm almost getting the idea of victims working with, it could be something in a hospital, working with patients, working with children, working with almost like social work, people who are going through the adoption agencies or process, or do you understand what I mean? People who need a little extra love in their life because they've lacked it for so long, you almost come in as a guardian angel to help these people. All right, let's pull you an oracle card. Yeah, stop. I don't want to use that term, but essentially, you're writing a novel based on prior experiences of things that's gone wrong. You need to be optimistic and look to the future. This is a card of Saturn, right? Saturn is the taskmaster, the heavy, the responsibility. You've already done the responsible thing. It's like, but I think it was passionless. It's time to kind of flip the script. And again, I'm not saying be irresponsible. You're Cancers. You would never do that anyway. But it's saying don't be afraid to have a little bit of fun. Step outside the comfort zone because, you know, no risk, no reward. Maybe that's why you're being asked to channel your Sagittarian energy. Sagittarian, welcome to Sagittarius season, by the way. It's like go big or go home, right? Jupiter energy, bigger, more, better. And it's fun though. It's jovial. It's enjoyment, right? Yeah, it's like channel your inner Sagittarius. In fact, look where that lies in your chart. What house is governed in your birth chart by Sagittarius? If you're Cancer rising, I think it would be your sixth house. Is that right? Correct me if I'm wrong. Anyway. So your work, your service may have to do with travel or philosophies or religions or something of the sort. There was one other thing I was going to say to you and I forgot what it was. Oh, well, doesn't matter. Give me an oracle card. What does Cancer need to heal? Coming up in your future, you have the Queen of Pentacles again. You have it twice. There could be a very important female dynamic. You may end up working with your sister or your best friend. Something, again, involving children, helping ill children, helping children to heal internal wounds. You act like a mother in metaphor for your job. And you may be connecting with a Capricorn, either romantically or financially. Rejection, 13. Yeah, that's fear, right? It happened once. What if it happens again? What if it doesn't? All right, I want one to actually pop out this time. And also, 13 is the death card. That's transformation from an old cycle and into a new one. I literally accidentally put it on the world. Again, it's like chapters. That's the old version of your life. That's what you used to settle for. There's movement. There's a almost like a wheel of fortune behind her. Again, Sagittarian vibes. Forward. Some of you stayed in a relationship well beyond its expiration date, and some of you are on the brink of divorcing or getting out of it, or you've already gotten out of it and you're immediately like, oh, did I make a mistake? No, you didn't. You're fine. Move forward, not backwards. The right people will find their way back into your life. You don't need to be the master manipulator of that and try and control it. Reunions are on the horizon for you, but especially with your female earth sign, your Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. And then beauty, 17. I love this. This is your card, Cancer. I love it. That snake, you're shedding the old skin. This is the new version of yourself. And again, something about, I am sort of getting like fancy ball gowns, like a costume fitting. Maybe you're going to be on stage or an actor or an actress or working with actors and actresses, appearing in a commercial. I don't know. There's something about your, yes, physical beauty, of course, take that if you would like to, but also it's like your internal beauty, your internal star, your internal light. We're trying to get that to shine through. Aquarian energy too. You may collaborate with an Aquarius on something that has been a long-term dream or passion of yours. Beauty. Show it off to the world. Don't keep it all to yourself. Shine. Shine like the little crabby cake that you are. And yeah, don't be afraid to leave the comfort zone. You have a lot of fours. Do you have all the fours? You have four of cups, you have four of swords, you have four of coins. And did you? Now you don't have four of pentacles, so that can indicate money. Yeah, but you have the three, so you're building it. You're building it. All right, Cancer, that's what I got for you. Let me know what you think of this new thing that I'm doing where I don't shuffle the cards in front of you when we first get started. I feel like people are eager to just jump into the reading, so rather than have me shuffle for 5 minutes, I feel like it's a good way to do it. I know some people prefer to see me shuffling, so for my longtime peeps who have been with me for a while, let me know what you think of this. If you like it, if you dislike it, that's fine. You can be honest, you know, be kind always. But yeah, let me know what you think of that. Other than that, thank you for joining me. Happy holidays to you. Go enjoy Sagittarius season and Capricorn season, and I will see you very soon for more Lil Sips Mini Love Tarot by Cancer.